I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Okay, Robert, you have a question from John Molina 948.
How? Is that John Molina the fighter?
No, because...
Or John Molina the guy I fought?
Probably. How the fuck is Brandon going to pull off the upset against Danny Garcia? I'm pulling for Brandon. That's what this fan says.
Brandon, he's been showing me his weight, and he's very good with weight. He's training very hard, he's motivated, and he's fucking sparring here. He's sparring his ass off. He's been in good shape, and he's got a good shot of beating Danny Garcia. Look, you know, Danny Garcia's a hell of a fighter. Hell of a fighter. He's coming back from a loss to Keith Thurman. Was it? He lost to Keith Thurman, right?
Yes.
Danny Garcia?
Yeah.
Okay. The plan is to rebuild him and get him in the top, you know, with the top welterweights. But people forget that he also has had some bad performances. And Brandon in good shape. Brandon in good shape and making weight the way he's doing so far. I think Brandon has a really good shot. What do you mean? How is he gonna? Brandon has that pressure, that power, that chin, that heart, that determination to beat anybody the way he thinks. There's nobody that could beat him when he's in top shape, when he's good, when he's ready. He could beat anybody. So why not Danny Garcia? I think he's got a good shot. I think he's gonna. Brandon's gonna pull it off.
Do you agree, Peter? Brandon's gonna pull it off.
Yeah.
Robert, we have some questions from fans. Ready?
Good morning.
Why is Lomachenko going after Tank at 130?
Because he's a 130 pounder and so is Tank, right?
No, but why not calling out 35 fighters?
He's still a 130 pounder, and I don't think he has plans of moving up to 135. He knows it's gonna be a big difference, and yes, he's got all the skills in the world. Yes, he has. He's pound for pound, probably number one or number two in the world, skills-wise. But that doesn't mean he could compete against way bigger guys that are also very talented. You know, you see the best welterweight out there. It's going to be really hard for a best welterweight out there to compete against a middleweight or a super middleweight. No matter how bad the middleweight is, it's still going to be hard.
Okay, someone named Legendary Boxer says, Robert, you're Trainer of the Year, Mikey is Fighter of the Year, and Frank is Chef of the Year.
That's a funny one.
Is he still the chef?
I've read a little bit of, about Abel Sanchez, myself.
No, the guy that trains
Virgil Hunter.
No, the guy that trains Earl Spence and Charlo should win.
Okay, well, and they also, because of Mikey, they're saying because Mikey had two good wins, but like people are forgetting that I also have Abner Mines, who is also a world champion.
And 20 other fighters.
And 20 other fighters, yes. So, you know, I don't know
how. The guy that trains Spence should win it.
But they're not even mentioning him.
Yeah, they are.
No, I haven't heard
him. He's going to win it.
I don't even know his name.
I don't know his name either, but he's the one that should win it.
I talked to one of the sparring partners of Errol Spence, who usually spars heavier people.
They usually, if they don't give it to Freddie Roach, they usually give it to, like, the guy that...
Virgil Hunter, what
like
did
the guy that had the newest world champs, like, instead of all defending champs, like, they gave it to, like, the newest. Well, like, when you won it, it was, like, Brandon was new champ, Mikey and Nonito, like, new. So this guy, Errol, won his title this year, and Charlo won his title. Or Charlo defended his title twice. And he knocked out Erickson.
Didn't Virgil Hunter beat Kobe?
Who did Virgil have?
Ward.
Yeah, with Ward, that's why. Because of Ward, twice. What? So that's probably why they're also mentioning
who lost?
Virgil Hunter, eh?
Virgil Hunter, who do you have? Who does he train?
Oh, Andre Ward, both times.
I was thinking of somebody else.
That's it. Well, he hasn't had anybody
else. I don't know how that should work.
Robert, can you give a shout out to Macario. San
Carrillo.
Jacinto.
Macario.
San Carrillo. Carrillo.
From San Jacinto, they're close by. My sister lives in San Jacinto. Shout out to Macario.
Don't they have a jail over there or something?
San Jacinto?
No?
No, there's a big casino there.
Okay.
There's a casino there.
Yeah. Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition. He abusing them.